Everybody loves to talk about how they want young people, but young people only when it's on the left. But now we have an opportunity where Republican conservative voices have a chance to be heard, making sure that we have a chance that can be louder than ever. I'm Mike LiPetri, Assemblyman for the 9th Assembly District. I came from a middle-class background. My mother's a nurse, my dad works utility, my grandmother was a widow. She was somebody that had to raise four children and came on to become one of the first women to obtain a law degree from St. John's University. My grandmother, my grandfather, is indicative of the American dream. My grandfather was a poor man in Brooklyn who grew up to have a shot in the major leagues where he pitched for the Philadelphia Phillies, roomed with Satchel Paige, heard amazing stories that we learned about the time back then and what he went through building to have an opportunity to pitch in the major leagues and achieve his dream. And for me, that's where I came from, is working hard. And I think we're missing that today in Congress. We're missing the people who actually understand what it means to grind, who actually understand what it means to work hard, to achieve their dreams, to achieve success. So I'm a millennial, and that's what's so great, is I'm a millennial Republican, somebody that stands up for an understanding what it means to work hard, what it means also to give back to the community. It's not about relying on government to do everything. It's understanding that a community has a civic duty to stand up and give back, engage in charity and charitable contributions. For me, I've seen it over time where I've seen what capitalism has done for this country. I mean, I live it every single day. You look at your phone, you got an iPhone, you got a Samsung Galaxy, you got different cell phones, you have different applications. It's all a result of capitalism. Uber, Lyft, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all as a result of capitalism. Those are products of innovation, ingenuity. And that's, as a millennial Republican, that's something that we need more and more as we grow and evolve as a country over the decades to come. So for me, you see many others that espouse these views of free, 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 but not really understanding the costs and ramifications they're gonna have on our generations. If we're gonna be a strong country in their future, we have to stand up and speak out and provide policies that are common sense, that make sense for law-abiding Americans, help us all grow and give each and every one of us an opportunity to flourish and achieve that American dream, just like my grandfather did. You see those in Congress like AOC, Ilhan Omar, the Squad, who are espousing these radical left-wing views. That's not for Americans. That's not helping each and every one of us who work hard to make ends meet. That's not being a voice for the people. And especially I see it in New York State right now, where you're seeing cash bail elimination, driver's licenses for people here illegally. How is that rewarding law-abiding Americans? In New York State, I had to fight people like the left-wing socialists, like AOC and the Squad and their minions. Over in New York State, I had to fight them. Why? Because they wanted to give free college tuition to people here illegally and yet reject free college tuition for Gold Star families. What's wrong with that? We have to make sure that we have people that are advocating for our veterans, for our middle class, for our law enforcement, for our unions, making sure we keep our environment safe in a way that doesn't destroy our economy. How about instead of focusing on climate change, we also focus on our water quality? Right in our backyards, we have problems, whether it be in New Jersey, Long Island, or Michigan. Issues with water pervade all across this country, yet nobody is bringing attention to it. Why? Because they don't care. No. What I'm about is somebody that actually cares about what's gonna make a difference for our future. Are we gonna preserve our future generations, or are we gonna watch us decline slowly? It's about maintaining strength. It's about being proud to be American, not shameful of this country. Being proud of what we stand for. We stand for liberty and justice for each and every one of us. It's about maintaining and pursuing that American dream. For those on the left, like AOC, they don't want that. For them, it's about control. For me, it's about freedom.